name is Milford Dagglebottom. And today, I'm going to be taking you around. How do I put this? The British Museum. Sure. Who made this sculpture? Whoever he was, he had a very good grasp on the male form. The detail in the phallus is particularly impressive. I'm sure you've all heard the expression, take the bull by the horns. My own expression. Take the bull by the balls. This crab or scorpion or whatever it is follows my philosophy. What is it? I've always liked pots. If we look here, we can quite clearly see a half man, half animal person swearing at some birds. Morgan Freeman. I've come across many things on this lecture. That's what it is, a lecture. But I have never seen a face so poorly drawn. We now approach the Nicki Minaj Gallery. Lord of the Rings, Harry Potter, Robin Hood, Ark of the Covenant. What's this? God knows. Origins of money. It started off as just things you found had value, such as this Magorn hoard. If we venture over this way, we see the beginnings of coinage. How it all started to become the money we know today. It was a simple time. The earliest coins found are these ones from the Turkish region of Lydia. And the very first polo you can see there. Counterfeiting has always been a problem. I'm just trying to spot any problems with these coins. They look fairly kosher. I don't know what the rabbit shit is doing in there. This is my favorite part of the museum. Clocks and watches. To a simple pocket watch. Intricate nature of the mechanics in a pocket watch. It's just dumbfounding, you know? Here we have Mount Rushmore. As you can see, there's been a bit of decay to the nose. Can't beat a good head. I can see from the writing This is a falcon-headed sphinx. It doesn't look like much of a falcon to me. It looks more like a vagina. Do you see the crack? What have we learned from today's museum musing? I think it's that no matter how old and magical a piece of art gets, it can still look like a vagina.